as China is born in China, and so I think nothing is more beautiful than this porcelain. To work with porcelain, it's so important to touch the Chinese clay because this is the motherland of porcelain.
And Jingdezhen has what I call creative energy or creative potential, which is this sort of source energy without sounding too kooky.
早在唐代开始，我们中国的陶瓷呢，就通过海上丝绸之路，甚至陆上丝绸之路呢，向世界各国呢传递贸易、交流。中国工匠生产的是陶瓷，那么到了海外之后呢，那么这些海外的工匠呢，又将中国的陶瓷进行加工，变成了东西方文化交融的一种产品。可以说，海外了解中国，通过了陶瓷。 那么中国也通过陶瓷来宣传、介绍了、推介了中国文化。
Here there is a learning where it's like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, you need to do it this way. Where we are like, oh, maybe we do 4 and 3 and 2, and you know, it could work out. So yeah, I think that this is the influence that foreigner brings to the young generation in Jingdezhen. Mm-hmm. Kind of just trying to get your own creative process, try, experience, yeah, make it yours.
You feel that you can do anything, you can make anything. And that's because there's layers and layers of history here of making, and it resonates. And you see it within all the products that have been made, the history here. And not only that, the city is actually changing pace too. All these building projects are happening. A lot of attention is being put into Jingdezhen from the Chinese government because Jingdezhen is its namesake, China, being China from Jingdezhen. And so every day I wake up and I feel this potential to create.